Hey, I just had a discussion with a friend, Adriana Williams, on Facebook. And I just guess I'm gonna get to the point. She feels that humanity is in trouble, the world is in trouble because of how we treat other humans. And I was trying to tell her that, you know, it also deals with how we treat the animals and the animal slaughter. This is not a pro-vegan video. Me personally, at this point, I don't care what nobody eats. You know, if you want to eat what you want to eat and you think that's in your best interest, who am I to tell you anything different? But I can only speak for myself. And I can only speak for what I've learned. Now, I'd like to share something with you that's based on scientific fact. So, it's not my opinion. It's not somebody's religion. I don't care. I'm just gonna lay the facts on you because that's my style. That's what Capri Scott does. I came to this planet to drop facts, you know what I'm saying? And it doesn't always lead to the best results, but ultimately it will. In the long run, it will. Nah, I didn't wash my face yet. I just been laying down all day and thinking about things, you know? For real, because sometimes you just need time alone to think and just self-help, self-medicating yourself in your mind, you know, meditation and medicating. All things are connected by invisible energy strings or energy cords. All things are connected. How do we know this? Because when the scientists point their cameras at the stars, they don't just use the visible light spectrum. They don't just use the 7 bands of color that we can see with our eyes. They use x-rays, they use gamma rays, cameras, microwave, cameras, lenses. So in one of these, I forgot the name of this particular satellite, but it actually, when they pointed it at the stars, they saw that there are energy highways between every single star in the universe. Every star in the universe is connected by cords of energy. For those of you who are familiar with a brother named, his name has recently been elevated to Sri Master Ganu Grills. I call him Prabhu Ganu, because it's a very similar. Prabhu means Lord or spiritual master. So no, it doesn't mean spiritual master. Prabhu means Lord. So I call him Prabhu Ganu Grills, but you know, I'm very familiar with him and he's a good brother. Sometimes he calls me and you know, we build for a few hours and he's a generous person too, you know. But in Ganu's seminars, in his lectures, in his gatherings, he often does something called the cutting of the karmic cords. And that's a real thing because we are all connected energetically. Now, I don't know if he's actually destroying people's karma or cutting their karma. Listen, I can't tell you because I haven't studied that part of his ministry, but I could tell that conceptually he's onto something. You know, because a real guru, a real spiritual master, when a person initiates you, they can take your karma and burn it up. You know what I'm saying? That is also the test of a spiritual master. But just borrowing this from Sri Master Ganu Grills is that there's something called karmic cords. So there are energetic strings that bind and connect all of us. So what this lady was saying was that basically we was talking about this meme that I shared. I got it from Ray Johnson, and in the meme it was showing a dead pig, 2 dead pigs, and at the top of the thing it said, "So you eat this, but you claim your P representing the physical sexual organs of the woman. You claim your P, or you know, the letter P, of course, smells like this." And then you see a picture of fruits. Because you know, a lot of people like to think or believe that their genitals smell better than they actually do, especially when they have a crazy diet consisting of dead animals. So how Adriana Williams responded was, well, it's more how humans treat each other on this world that matters and this and that. And I told her, That's true. It matters how humans treat each other. But we can't pretend that the animals are not a part of this world we live in. And until it's proven that there's life on other planets and other civilizations and aliens and all of that, we are all we have. One world, one globe, one planet. Whether you are animal, whether you are human, or you're a plant, we share this planet together. So if there's energy cords that connect the stars, I'm pretty sure there's energy cords that connect me and you to the animals and to the plants, and vice versa. And this is what people don't understand. So she was talking about humans treating each other bad and we gotta fix that. Listen, human civilization cannot be fixed while abusing other people. That's like a Jew who would go through the Holocaust and then turn around in 1947 and get a country and start doing the same stuff to other people. That's like a black man who's being abused through whatever means, slavery or whatever. Then we turn around and do it to our women or our children, or we become police and do it to each other. That's like the European Caucasian man who was dominated by Moors. And I want to point something out special about that. The Moorish history of conquering Europe for nearly 1,000 years, it wasn't so much through warfare. When those Moors came to Europe, the bridges, everything was broken down. It was dark ages, it was very dirty. As a matter of fact, if you want a good idea of what Europe was like when the Moors arrived there, just go to California, go to San Francisco. From what I hear, the city streets are filled with feces and needles. And so basically back in the days, the European people, the Gentile people used to, their bathroom was not a sewer, their bathroom was a bucket tossed out the window. You could be walking down a block and that stuff just comes down on you. Urine, feces, menstrual blood. That was their bathroom system before the Blackamoors came there and taught them ways of cleanliness, math, science, and engineering. It's a fact. They don't like to talk about it because everybody wants to believe that Africans know nothing and we've contributed nothing to civilization. And I'm gonna let you stay in your ignorance, because as long as you're harming me, your self-harm is also assured. Remember that. You harm me, you're gonna be harmed. You even wish harm on me, you're gonna be harmed by the wishes of others. So it's like a European Caucasian Gentile being enslaved or ruled over by the Moors for 700 to 1,000 years, and then they wanna go around the world and do it to the rest of the people. Humans don't see the stupidity and the futility of their actions. If we don't take care of each other, if we don't care each other, we will tear each other. This is for black, white, I don't care. As long as you're on this earth, especially you human beings, you're supposed to be the most intelligent beings on the face of the planet, and you're still slaughtering other animals, and you think it's cool. And you know what? I'm talking now directly to my Muslim friends out there. Yo, Muslims are the most staunch people when it comes to killing animals. There's a lady that I know, and I'm not gonna, you know, throw her under the bus, but she thinks animals are dumb and stupid. And when I tell her animals should not be eaten, she says, why? Why not kill the animals? She can't even fathom that another living entity is feeling pain because of her religion. Her religion advocates the slaughtering of these animals, you know? And it's a damn shame that human beings can't look past their religion for 1 second to look to the plane of common sense. So yeah, the slaughter industry, Srila Prabhupada was right. The reason why we have so many wars and why people is getting bombed up in Syria and police is killing Negroes in America and in Malaysia there's ethnic violence and the Rohingyas is getting chased out of this part of Bangladesh and Myanmar and Trump. The reason why people like Trump exist is because we keep causing pain to other living entities, whether it's the plant kingdom or the animal kingdom. Yes, you have to eat something to survive. Nobody's saying you don't eat, but at least you want to take food from the lower consciousness strata, like the plants and the vegetables. They do feel pain, but there's at least they don't protest as much. And you can purify that pain just by simply offering it to Krishna. Again, this wasn't meant to be a religious or a spiritual video. It's actually a scientific video, but there are ways to alleviate the karma of a plant-based diet as well. There's no ways to alleviate the karma of an animal-based diet, believe it or not. Some people believe you could offer it to Durga, but Durga is the mother of all. Does your mother feel happy when people kill her kids and eat them? So why would Durga feel happy? Or Mother Kali feel happy because you're offering her a dead goat? We're fooling ourselves. So yeah, if for the humans who have stopped killing animals to satisfy their tongue, you will notice a shift in your karma and in the things that happen to you. Now, I wish everybody would wake up, because if the stars are connected, we can travel to the stars at the speed of thought. A lot of the technology to do that is being held. Yo, they got stuff in your local police department right now. Evidence boxes in your central bookings, in your courthouse. Evidence that may or may not have been turned over to the government. That can alleviate a lot of the suffering in the world.